Evening, folks. Welcome back to Mecha Taco. I'm your host, Jason, and we are not playing Dark Forces tonight. Are you excited about that? I'm excited about that. And as a special celebration for not playing Dark Forces, we are going to play Bust a Move. Very red. Originally, Bust a Groove in Japan. Bust a Move in Japan, Bust a Groove in the States. Renamed for trademark reasons, obviously. This game actually is probably the game that got me back into the rhythm genre. And, you know, I can't explain why, because it's very simple. It's still just a lot of fun, and the music is a lot of fun, and we are going to play that tonight, so let's go ahead and get started here. Let's turn that off. Let's reset our audio. And let's go here. All right. Oh shoot. I screwed it up. Hang on. Come on, come back. There we go. No, now it's small. And now it's big. Okay. We're back in order. Ugh, why am I so red? Oh, yeah. Remember when CG intros were like the most amazing thing ever? Believe it or not, they did not look quite as grainy running through an actual like TV. Alright. Oh, is there an option? Ah, it doesn't matter. All right. Who are we gonna play as? Yes. The unintentionally racist characterization sometimes. Ham was edited. We'll get to Ham once we get there. Are we Hero or Frida? Let's be Frida. Alright, let's turn my volume up a little bit so I can hear the music. Now, I'm not going to talk a lot during the game because you really kind of have to concentrate. Every fourth beat is when you push the button. You'll understand what I mean when I get there. Thank you. I'm a little rusty. I apologize. All right, kind of fever time though. Crap. Kelly. It's a slow song. Kelly is special. I'm just gonna leave it like that. You think slow would be easier? You'd be wrong. The better you do, the crazier the background gets. Just little touches like that make the game neat. Thankfully, her song is mercifully short. Yeah, no fever time that time. That wasn't happening. So red. Oh, Shorty, yay. There we go. Add a little yellow to the mix. Oh, I don't care. I gotta fix my webcam. That's ridiculous. I'm so red. You know what? Let's pause it here real quick. And I really have to fix. Oh, where are my webcam settings? Sorry, folks. Technical difficulties. There we go. It's crazy how yellow I am. It's driving me up a freaking wall. Alright, close that. There we go. And let's see if I can. I'm either yellow or red, and there's no in between. That doesn't work. Leave that on. Color intensity. There you go. Oh, hey. There, now I look a little bit more human by taking the color out. You know, we'll go with that. That's not too bad. Ah. How do I look? Do I look good? Pretty sharp? Okay. We'll go with that for now. Now let's fix our screen here. We're little. Oh, now we're big. Retry, please. Yeah, the moment you pause it, that's it. You have to either quit or retry. Okay. We're going to do better this time anyway. Now that we had our little break. We're good. That was rough. I'm still excited I got at least one freeze time. It's early. It's never very good at Pinky stage.
Thank you.
at that time.
You lose. Yep.
Now, I just realized, I don't think I made it clear, this is a PlayStation game. If the warbling polygons weren't evidence of that enough. Not too surprising. But I'm running this through an emulator, which is why, while we still have the warbling going on, the polygons are nice and smooth. I haven't really messed around with a whole lot of other PlayStation emulators, so I don't know if there's a better one. Time. Yeah, sit down, kid. I don't know what I was saying. I'm so distracted. Your mid-boss bonus stage. This game is really cool, especially for a PlayStation game. Every time. Not bad. You win. I just want to point out, I appreciate the fact that I can see Frida's underwear. Just a nice little detail. Ah, should have gotten a freeze time. Oh, Hero-kun! Hero-kun they censored in the American version. He has a cigarette here, and they took that out. This is the best song in the entire game, in my opinion. Crap, hang on, I have to restart. I was too busy listening to the song. Oh, I love it. Sorry, I didn't mean to kill the lyrics, because the lyrics are fabulous. Okay, one more time. Thank you. And yes, you can attack each other during the songs, which will screw you up. And obviously it'll mess up your combo if you fail. You can dodge it as long as you time it right. Oh, Ham. Ham was censored, again, in the Western version. For reasons that escape me. His song and his character was changed a little bit. If ever there was a stain on the game, the not-at-all-racist Ham. I'm having trouble just paying attention to the song. Oh, jeez. Oh, come on, don't lose to Ham. Because I don't want to play. I want to play Ham stage again. Almost. What were they thinking? Like, oh yeah, this should be fine. Please, 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 please just pass. You thank you. It's just a weird ass. Very, very strange caricature. Frida versus he. I mean, the game itself is kind of strange, but that Ham is. I don't know. Ham is special. Now we're done messing around. Be really good at this game, and that saddens me a little bit that I've lost that. I'm sure if I had sat there and played it over and over and over again for like a week, I'd do a lot better. I like Strike's design, despite the fact that he's dual wielding. I like all the designs, with the exception of probably Ham. Okay, hang on, sorry. I was too busy thinking of Ham. One more time. Listen to the lyrics of the song, by the way. It's fascinating. Schwarzenegger, I'm the only true eraser. It's my favorite line. Strike's got it this time. Yeah. Oh, hey, I did. I'm shocked. The focus was on him half the time. I figured he would get it. I was wondering when my mirror match would come up. Yeah, alternate Frida does look cool too. And go Frida. Sorry, guys. I have to restart. That was terrible. I should have done so much better. Almost had it. Almost had it. Almost had it. One freeze time this entire playthrough. It's been a while. Leave me alone. One of my favorite boss battles in gaming. Right here. The scale. That's the only reason. I adore it. That ends ridiculous. Of course we're going to continue. We can take out Rosen Z. This is nothing. I was too distracted. You guys are distracting me. That time.
You win.
Thank you. She's an artist. She's a sensitive artist. The endings really don't get any better than that. I should state that. It is a really, really cool game. And, yeah, I mean, if you can get a hold of the Japanese version, I highly recommend it. The music, in my opinion, is better. You know, censorship issues, as I said, there's only like a handful of things that are censored. It's no big deal. I mean, Ham has been modified slightly. So he's slightly less offensive. He's still pretty dang offensive, though. You know, the biggest thing to me is Hiro's cigarette, which is, you know, it's part of his awesome character. His two-player design has a shirt that just says, I love me on it. There he is. I love Hiro. Hiro's great. Unlockables. You can unlock Capoeira. I can't remember if you can unlock Robo-Z or not. It's been a long time. I played the hell out of this game when it came out. This was like my go-to PlayStation game for the longest time. And I remember when Bust a Move 2 came out, I was pretty excited, and then I played it, and I don't know, it just didn't have the same feel. I don't know if it was the music that was off, or what it was. I don't know if Avex Tracks had anything to do with it. But I could not get into Bust a Move 2, and I do want to play it again. There was a Bust a Move 3, technically, for the PlayStation 2. Early PlayStation 2. It was called, like, Bust a Move, like, World Tour or something. It was weird. It was a strange little game. It was like a four-player game or something. Crazy. I'll have to see if I can try to emulate it or something, because, honestly, like, I've only messed around with it a little bit, and it was just off-putting. It was so strange. 1998. Hey, party people! Time to get your groove on. Like Dance View. Let's see. Excuse me. Come on, Hiro. Oh, I can only do Frida. Dance View can only select the characters that you've beaten the game with. So, in that case. And it's exactly what you think it does. You can go through the entire process. Let's make her go through fever. I mean, the amount of variety and paths that you can unlock as you play is really, really cool. Fever 2. Oops. Let's see. I mean, there's quite a bit of detail in the game, quite honestly. Let's set her up for... Jeez, yeah. Just keeps going. Well, individual, come on, we don't want that. That's ridiculous. This is the worst dance routine I'm creating, by the way. Just so you know. Oh, crap. Then I went and screwed it up. No, don't lose. You're fine. Oh, she's mad. And win. There. Slow things down, or speed it up, whatever. I mean, this is a nice-looking PlayStation game. You know, again, granted, I am running it at a higher resolution. And the frame rate is low. It's PlayStation. But it's still really, really cool. There you go. And I mean, this little mode is just super cool. Just sit there and watch. Bust a Move. I said in the US it was called Bust a Groove for trademark reasons. But if you can find it, I highly, highly recommend it. It still plays beautifully on a PlayStation. I get to stare at this. This is like a super cool screensaver here. It's got that PlayStation warble going on. You can't get away from that. Alright, so I'm not going to go through another character right now. Let's save that for, you know, when I'm really desperate for another game. I've been wanting to play this one for a while, and when I had played Cool Cool Tune, it was honestly between Cool Cool Tune and Bust a Move. And Cool Cool Tune won out, but Bust a Move is definitely up there of my favorite rhythm games. I think I like this better than Parappa the Rappa, and I like Parappa the Rappa quite a bit, but for different reasons. Parappa is just a really bizarre-ass game, and the lyrics are hysterical. This one is just, it's actually fun to play. Again, very simplistic. You know, every fourth beat, you push the button. The command inputs you can input at any time during the beats. You don't have to, you know, input it per beat. But as long as you push the button on the fourth beat, you're fine. And of course, you know, the beat time changes based on the song. And you don't have to stick to the commands that are being shown on the screen. You can, if you've memorized the other commands, you can input those as well. So there's a lot of variety and stuff you can do. It is a cool game. It really is, and you know, I cannot recommend this one enough. If you're into rhythm games, I mean, come on. If you're not, one, you haven't watched it this far. Two. You're not going to go out and buy an ancient, you know, 19-year-old, God, 19-year-old PlayStation game. The game is legal. That's so weird. 19. 18, actually, my math is off. It's still ridiculous. That game should not be this old. I was thinking it was 2018 for some reason. I don't know. I don't know why. I'm tired. It's late. I'm just going to sit there and watch Frida dance. All right, folks. I'm out for tonight. Tomorrow, who knows what we're going to be playing. We'll. I don't know if we'll do another, you know, epic saga or if we'll just do another little one-shot like this. We'll wait and see. Until then... You know, thank you again for joining me. As always, I always appreciate it. And, very slick. I will, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Good night, all.